Now, a color in astronomy is very simply a difference in magnitudes obtained with different bands, say a band B1 and B2. Because of this and the way that we define magnitudes, remember that if we look at the difference of magnitudes, you're essentially looking at the ratio of fluxes, then a color in astronomy is really a proxy for the ratio of fluxes, of essentially how bright the same source is at some sort of longer wavelength and shorter wavelength. And in general, the way we write this, apart from using something like, let's say the color between B and V, we can write it as MB minus MV, or simply B minus V. So if you're asked to calculate the B minus V color, this is what you're trying to do. And if you know the fluxes of that source in the B and V bands, you can also do this. Now, a convention that we use in astronomy and that I have here, and you'll also find in your lecture notes explained quite clearly, is that we typically, when we look at colors, we typically are subtracting a color from a bluer band from a color on a redder band. This is what I try to convey by using lambda minus, lambda plus. This is a magnitude at a longer wavelength, a magnitude at a shorter wavelength. What we mean when we say that a source is red is typically, it means that a color is higher than zero when we define it this way. And if an object is blue, it means this is below zero. So there's nothing like trying a specific example to see if you actually understood it, and you have this also in your lecture notes. So let's go back to the source that we're now familiar with. We've seen how its flux density is changing with wavelengths before. And for now, let's just define these filters. So the B filter, then the V band filter that you can see here, and also the R band filter. And they're defined so that it's very simple to integrate, right? So the B band filter is going from 4,000 to 5,000. The V band filter goes to 6,000. And then the R band filter goes from 6,000 to 7,000. So if you want to calculate colors by using fluxes, all you have to do is to repeat one of the first examples we did. And you do it for the B band, then you do it for V and then R, and then you just subtract. So that is obviously one of the ways that you can do that. You can calculate the different magnitudes and then calculate colors, or you can calculate colors directly just by looking at the ratios of fluxes. So depending on what you're trying to do, you can do either. Specifically for this case, if you want to calculate the fluxes of the blue band, V band, and R band, these would be the answers. And finally, once you have the fluxes, if you want to calculate the colors as ratios of the fluxes, you need to do minus 2.5 log 10 of the ratios. And you will realize that all these colors are red, so they're all higher than zero. And also that the longest baseline meaning shortest wavelength minus the longest wavelength, gives you the highest color or the highest magnitude difference. So it is important to note that even though this is the same source, and actually if you look at the spectrum, I mean, it's not necessarily redder or more inclined at any specific wavelength, but because of the definition, if a source is rising towards the red, if you use a longer baseline, these magnitude difference will be larger. Okay, so this is, it's very important, but in this case, the source will be red in any magnitude difference because of the way that we defined it.